What was your big takeaway from the training? What did you, what tip did you learn that you're going to use when telling the story?
I learned it's important to connect with the audience, number one. It's also important to keep it simple. Even though the topic may be complex and very scientific, you keep it simple so people can follow it, pay attention and get excited about it, and do something with it. I grew up in a small town in Puerto Rico, and I was raised by my grandparents, and I learned English as a second language. When I was three, I told my grandma, Gramps, I'm gonna be one of those people who builds houses. I meant architect, but I didn't know the word. I became a mechanical engineer. She didn't know the difference, but I made her proud. She did not imagine that I was going to be hired by the premier environmental agency in the world, leave home, and become a global environmentalist. I started at EPA in Superfund Enforcement and moved on to air enforcement and to atmospheric programs and climate partnerships. Today, I work in EPA's Office of International and Tribal Affairs, and I manage our programs to build awareness and capacity for environmental protection in China. Together with many experts from EPA, I work with our Chinese counterparts to build that capacity. On a variety of topics, by the way. But there's one project that I'm absolutely passionate about. And you all must know that the US and China are major trading partners. And I'm working on promoting sustainability of the marine transport between our countries. See, the products we enjoy every day are not teleported, not to the store, not to the supermarket, and not to our front door. They're transported long distances through a global network of trucks, trains, and vessels. And you might think, why worry about the vessels? They're out in the ocean. But EPA studies and models show that air pollution from vessels along our coasts impact air quality as far inland as Nebraska. Now, the cool part is that working with the states, with academia, with NGOs, with industry and our communities, we have developed cost-effective solutions to reduce environmental impacts in the US. Now, we also know that pollution doesn't stop at the border. Pollution from the US impacts other countries, and pollution from other countries impacts the US. And all of it impacts the global environment. But here's the cool part. We're also working on that. And we're working on that because others around the world look to EPA for environmental excellence. And when we share our experience, we help their environment, we help our environment, and we help the planet. And I have the privilege of leading this project that brings together stakeholders from China and the US to reduce emissions from ports and vessels. And in June of 2015, at the US and China Strategic and Economic Dialogue, the two governments agreed to expand this project by launching a formal initiative. And as I look at my work with China, I think my grandma would be proud, because I left small and lovely Puerto Rico and I get to work with the two largest economies in the world to make my contribution to the sustainability of our planet. I'm very proud of how it went, because it's a different way of storytelling, actually a different way from what I'm used to saying, speeches versus story told. And I was able to tell my story and convey my passion for the topic, and also inspire others to share their experience with others around the world and explain why EPA does what EPA does.